just like that, 50,070. And God Almighty is watching and He's allowing those 50,070 to pass. And then He massacres them all, and he widows 50,000 women, and He orphans 100,000 children, and you call this a God of mercy. You know that's your Bible? For looking into a box, God killed 50,070.
Would you show me what that is?
Yes.
Thank you.
Yeah, that's interesting.
Right. It is the book of Samuel, 1 Samuel 6:19. 1 Samuel 6:19. Yeah. 1 Samuel 6:19.
Oh, okay. Understand.
Right, read it.
Yes, I'm here.
Read it.
Oh, it says, and he smote the men of Beth Shemesh, because they had looked into the ark of the Lord. Even he smote of the people 50,010 men. And the people lamented, because the Lord had smitten many of the people with a great slaughter.
50,070 people. God slaughters. The merciful God, the loving Father in heaven, He widows 50,000 women, and He orphans 150,000 children for looking into a box. But not committing incest with his daughters is gone, is reprieved. That guy committing incest with his mother is reprieved. And Judah committing incest with his daughter now is reprieved. Then Amnon, he raped his sister, he's reprieved. And Absalom, he raped 10 of his father's wives wholesale, he's reprieved. This is in your holy book. But for looking into a box, he kills 50,070 persons. You call him a merciful God, the loving Father in heaven. Is this the quality of a merciful Father?
Yes.
My child makes a mistake. The first child, I stop him. If I give you instruction that, look, there's a box here, I don't want anybody to look inside. When you go out, you go out. Anybody looking into the box, I'll kill you. And I'm serious. I'm in business. The first guy who looks into the box, I will shout. Say, John! I said, sorry, my Lord, I forgot. And I'm such a sadist. I'm so vengeful, I can't forgive. So I chop off his head. But I'm saving 50,069. Am I correct? If I got rid of that first guy who looked into the box, if I killed him, I'm saving 50,069. But I am a sadistic God. You see, the first guy went, I said, right, too little. Second, 100, 1,000, 5,000, 10,000, 20,000, 30,000. My mouth is watering. I'm vengeful. I'm bloodthirsty. And until 50,000, the whole bang lot. Now I kill them all. Mercy. That's a sign of mercy. Now love. Is that love? You tell me now. Incest is okay in the book of God. No, not one word against it.
No, incest
is not okay.
But not one word against it.
Understand. But
nobody is punished.
But incest is not okay.
But I'm telling you, not one of those guys, that Judah, he commits incest with his daughter-in-law, and he's blessed by becoming the great grandfather of your God, Jesus Christ. So there's not a single punishment or reproach. There's not one word there about a reproach to Judah, is there? In your book. Now this is what your Americans are reading, your Bible thumpers, and you behave that way. Child molestation. Child molestation in your country has reached endemic proportions. And people prohibiting with their own daughters. Their own three-year-old and four-year-old daughters.
Right.
Because the type of stuff that you eat, if you eat garbage, your mental process will become garbage.
Not now.
If you eat rubbish, your mind become rubbish.
Okay.
If you read rubbish, you behave rubbish.
Okay. Yeah. Now, again, we've already established the point that it doesn't matter whether you read rubbish or not, that you have the inclination to these passions.
Right.
Okay.
Right.
Now, in Islam,
right,
is there not compassion, or is there punishment for such acts?
No, there are punishments. You see, in Islam, you highway robbery, so chop off your hands.
Okay.
Right. Burglary.
All right.
Forced entry. chop off your hands.
Sure.
To which the Westerner, the Christian, is complaining to us that you people are heartless. Your God is a merciless God. He's a bloodthirsty God. This is the charge that the Americans and the Britishers and the French and the Germans are making against the Saudis. Mm-hmm. I have visited this country dozens of times, but I have not seen a single guy with his hands chopped off. That doesn't mean it hasn't happened, or it's not happening. It must be there, but I haven't seen one yet.
Yeah.
But now I want you to tell me, honestly, that if your father and mother are sleeping, and a burglar gets in, and your dad wakes up and grapples with the burglar, but the burglar is too powerful, he floors him, sits on his chest and strangles him to death. Your old mother comes to the rescue and rescues your father. Your father is rescued, freed him from that burglar. Now your dad tells you, says, son, chop off your mother's hands. Chop off her hands. For what saving his life? Chop off her hands. So you say, daddy, are you joking? No, are you joking? Look, she saved your life. And now you say, chop off her hands. Are you joking? He said, no, my son, I'm serious. He said, daddy, have you taken some drugs or alcohol? You must be drunk. He says, no, my son, I'm inspired. He said, daddy, who inspires you? He says, God. I said, no, daddy, this is not the work of God. A woman saves your life and you chop off her hands. I can understand the Arabs chopping off a guy's hands for robbery, for burglary. Okay, maybe they're too hard, they're too harsh. And they'll give you rationalization that, look, as a result of that, we have hardly any to the extent that you have in your own country. You know, the same type of crimes are very few. They're happening, but they're very few because of this law, the fear. I can understand the Arabs, but daddy, you a good Christian, you know, you Seventh-day Adventist, and you Jehovah's Witness. No. This is the inspiration of the devil. Am I right? If your father tells that your mother's hands must be chopped off for saving his life, it is the devil that's inspiring him and not God. You agree? Do you agree that your father is inspired by the devil?
Well, I lost track of how do we get off on someone getting their hands chopped off or saving someone's life.
Right. So if your dad says he's inspired by God, he heard the voice of God telling him, chop off the woman's hands. Then you say, look, this is not God inspiring you, daddy. It is the inspiration of the devil.
Oh, yeah. Because we don't command.
If your father,
that perspective, the way you put it.
Right.
Yeah, that's crazy.
According to that perspective, is it crazy or is it sanity? Same. For your father to chop off your mother's hands. I'm asking you, is it sanity or lunacy? What is your judgment? What I gave you the example, your mother saved your father's life, and now he says chop off her hands, and he's inspired by God. It's the devil that's inspiring him, you agree? If your father says God told him to chop off your mother's hand for saving his life, he said, daddy, this is the work of the devil. No God, no sane person can ever give such an advice. Am I right?
In the way you frame the question, yes.
Right. In the way I frame the question, right. That is the devil who's inspiring that. Now open Deuteronomy chapter 25. Open Deuteronomy chapter 25 verse 11. Open your book. And you read it in Spanish. Do yourself. 25, 11 and 12. Here's my brother, Seventh-day Adventist. I like the Bible.
It says, when men strive together one with another, and a wife of one draweth near for to deliver her husband out of the hand of him that smiteth him, and putteth forth her hand, and taketh him by the secrets, then thou shalt cut off her hand, thine eye shall not pity her.
Right. Is this the word of God? Does God give you such advice? That the woman come to save your father's life and now chop off her hands and your eye must not pity. No mercy must be shown. Is this God's word or the devil's word?
This is God's word.
God's word.
Does God give? This is the charge that the Americans and the Britishers and the French and the Germans are making against the Saudis.
Mm-hmm.
I have visited this country dozens of times, but I have not seen a single guy with his hands chopped off. That doesn't mean it hasn't happened, or it's not happening. It must be there, but I haven't seen one yet.
Yeah.
But now I want you to tell me, honestly, that if your father and mother are sleeping, and a burglar gets in, and your dad wakes up and grapples with the burglar, but the burglar is too powerful. He floors him, sits on his chest and is strangling him to death. Your old mother comes to the rescue and rescues your father. Your father is rescued, freed him from that burglar. Now your dad tells you, says, son, chop off your mother's hands. Chop off her hands. For what? Saving his life. Chop off her hands. So you say, daddy, are you joking?
No,
are you joking? Look, she saved your life. And now you say, chop off her hands. Are you joking? He said, no, my son, I'm serious. He said, daddy, have you taken some drugs or alcohol? Mm-hmm. You must be drunk. Mm-hmm. He says, no, my son, I'm inspired. He said, daddy, who inspires you? He says, God. I said, no, daddy, this is not the work of God. A woman saves your life and you chop off her hands. I can understand the Arabs chopping off a guy's hands for robbery, for burglary. Okay. Maybe they're too hard, they're too harsh. And they'll give you rationalization that, look, as a result of that, we have hardly any to the extent that you have in your own country. You know, the same type of crimes are very few. They're happening, but they're very few. Because of this law, the fear. I can understand the Arabs, but daddy, you, a good Christian, you know, you Seventh-day Adventist, and you Jehovah's Witness. No. This is the inspiration of the devil. Am I right? If your father tells that your mother's hands must be chopped off for saving his life, it is the devil that's inspiring him and not God. You agree? Do you agree that your father is inspired by the devil?
Well, I lost track of how do we get off on someone getting their hands chopped off or saving someone's life.
Right. So if your dad says he's inspired by God, he heard the voice of God telling him, chop off the woman's hands. Then you say, look, this is not God inspiring you, daddy. It is the inspiration of the devil.
Oh, yeah. Because we don't command.
If your father,
that perspective, the way you put it.
Right.
Yeah, that's crazy.
According to that perspective, is it crazy or is it sanity? Same. For your father to chop off your own mother's hands. I'm asking you, is it sanity or he widows 50,000 women and he orphans 100,000 children and you call this a God of mercy? You know that's your Bible? For looking into a box, God killed 50,070.
Would you show me what that is?
Yes.
Thank you.
Yeah, that's interesting.
Right. It is the book of Samuel, 1 Samuel 6:19.
1 Samuel 6:19.
Hmm. Oh, okay. Understand. Right, read it?
Yes, I'm here.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. Read it, I
want to
hear.
Oh, it says, and he smote the men of Beth Shemesh.
Uh-huh.
Because they had looked into the ark of
uh-huh.
the Lord.
Uh-huh.
Even he smote of the people 70,010 men.
Uh-huh. 70.
And the people lamented because the Lord
lamented.
Had smitten many of the people with a great slaughter.
50,070 people. God slaughters. The merciful God, the loving Father in heaven, he widows 50,000 women and he orphans 150,000 children for looking into a box. But not committing incest with his daughters is gone, is reprieved. That guy committing incest with his mother is reprieved. And Judah committing incest with his daughter now is reprieved. Then Amnon, he rapes his sister, he's reprieved. And Absalom, he rapes 10 of his father's wives wholesale, he's reprieved. This is in your holy book. But for looking into a box, he kills 50,070 persons. You call him a merciful God, the loving Father in heaven. Is this the quality of a merciful Father?
Yes.
My child makes a mistake. The first child, I stop him. If I give you instruction that, look, there's a box here. I don't want anybody to look inside. When you go out, you go out. Anybody looking into the box, I'll kill you. And I'm serious. I'm in business. The first guy who looks into the box, I will shout. Say, John! I said, sorry, my lord. I forgot. And I'm such a sadist. You know, I'm so vengeful, I can't forgive. So I chop off his head. But I'm saving 50,069. Am I correct? If I got rid of that first guy who looked into the box, if I killed him, I'm saving 50,069. But I am a sadistic God. You see, the first guy went, I said, right, too little. Second, 100, 1,000, 5,000, 10,000, 20,000, 30,000. My mouth is watering. I'm vengeful. I'm bloodthirsty. Until 50,000, the whole bank run. 100, 1,000, 5,000, 10,000, 20,000, 30,000. My mouth is watering. I'm vengeful. I'm bloodthirsty. Until 50,000, the whole bank rot. Now I kill them all. Mercy. That's a sign of mercy. Now love. Is that love? You tell me now. Incest is okay in the book of God. No, not one word against it.
No, incest is
not okay.
But not one word against it.
Understand. But
nobody is punished.
But incest is not okay.
But I'm telling you, not one of those guys, that Judah, he commits incest with his daughter-in-law, and he's blessed by becoming the great grandfather of your God, Jesus Christ. So there's not a single punishment or reproach. There's not one word there about a reproach to Judah, is there? In your book. Now this is what your Americans are reading, your Bible thumpers, and you behave that way. Child molestation. Child molestation in your country has reached endemic proportions. And people prohibiting with their own daughters.
Yes, true.
Their own three-year-old and four-year-old daughters.
Yes, true.
Right. Sinners and
because the type of stuff that you eat, if you eat garbage, you know, your mental process will become garbage.
Now.
If you eat rubbish, your mind will become rubbish.
Okay.
If you read rubbish, you behave rubbish.
Okay. Yeah. Now, again, we've already established the point that it doesn't matter whether you read rubbish or not, that you have the inclination to these passions.
Right.
Okay.
Yes.
Now, in Islam,
right,
is there not compassion or is there punishment for such acts?
No, there are punishments. You see, in Islam, you highway robbery, so chop off your hands.
Okay.
Right. A burglary.
All right.
Fast entry. Chop off your hands.
Sure.
To which the Westerner, the Christian, is complaining to us that you people are heartless. Your God is a merciless God. He's a bloodthirsty God. This is the charge that the Americans and the Britishers and the French and the Germans are making against the Saudis.
Mm-hmm.
I have visited this country dozens of times, but I have not seen a single guy with his hands chopped off. That doesn't mean it hasn't happened. Or it's not happening. It must be there. But I haven't seen one yet.
Yeah.
But now I want you to tell me, honestly, that if your father and mother are sleeping, and a burglar gets in, and your dad wakes up and grapples with the burglar, but the burglar is too powerful, he floors him, sits on his chest and is strangling him to death. Your old mother comes to the rescue, and rescues your father. Your father is rescued, freed him from that burglar. Now,